In this lesson, we're going to take those polynomials that we've begun to work with, and we're going to perform addition or subtraction on them. And you add or subtract polynomials by using the integer rules for addition or subtraction on the coefficients of like terms. You add or subtract polynomials by using the integer rules for addition and subtraction on the coefficients of like terms. Let's see if I can show you a couple of examples. Let's suppose I have 3x squared plus 5x minus 8, and I add to it 7x squared minus 14x minus 3. All right, because I'm adding, I'm going to add a 3x squared and a 7x squared. Now, let me just say something that has been very helpful to me. This is a trinomial. This is a trinomial. But when it comes time to add or subtract, all I worry about are like terms. What's in front of this parentheses is an implied 1, which means I could actually remove that parentheses. What's in front of this one? An implied positive 1. So I could remove it. So now I am just going to be adding using the addition rules for like terms. I have a 3x squared and a 7x squared, which add together for 10x squared. I have 5x and negative 14x. One positive, one negative. I subtract, keep the sign of the bigger one, which is negative 9x. Then finally, I have a minus 8 and a minus 3. They're both negative. Add them up, keep it negative for negative 11. I have added those polynomials by adding the like terms coefficients. Now, when I have subtraction, let's take the same polynomials, 3x squared plus 5x minus 8, and subtract 7x squared minus 14x minus 3. Back when you worked with integers, positives and negatives, for the first time, you might remember that subtraction was defined to be adding the opposite of the second number. In other words, it was, in my terminology, keep, change, change. For example, if you had 3 minus 8, you might change, keep 3, change to addition, change 8 to its opposite, and that gives you negative 5. We changed our subtraction to addition. Well, I'm going to do the same thing with polynomials. I will keep the first polynomial. It's preceded by an implied positive 1, and I can just ignore or remove those parentheses. But the second set is preceded by a negative. I'm going to change it to addition, but I have to distribute that negative, which causes every term inside to change. So keep the first polynomial, change to addition, change every sign in the second one. If you want to, you could have thought of it as distributing a negative 1 to everything. Now, I have 3x squared and negative 7x squared for negative 4x squared. I have a plus 5x and a plus 14x for plus 19x. I have a minus 8 and a plus 3, which gives me minus 5. This is the difference between the two. All right, so now let's look at some more problems to practice. Number one, I have 3x plus 3 plus 2x plus 2. Because these are both preceded by implied positive ones, I can ignore the parentheses. In my mind, I see that these are like terms, and I see, whoops, that it's gone. There we go. That these are like terms. So what does that give me? 3x plus 2x is 5x. 3 plus 2 is 5. These are not like terms, so I'm done. All right, next one. I have negative 3x plus 10 plus negative 12x squared plus 3x minus 6. All right, like terms. Well, here is an x squared term. There are no other x squared terms, so I'm going to put negative 12x squared as my first term. Then I have a negative 3x and a positive 3x. Well, those are opposites, so that's canceled out. And I do have a plus 10 and a minus 6, which gives me plus 4. I have combined terms that were alike. Now, this third problem is subtraction. I have 5x squared plus 9 minus parentheses 9x squared minus 1. Now, every time I deal with a subtraction problem, I always keep the first one, I change to addition, and it is as if I distributed the negative, I change. Now I have 5x squared minus 9x squared gives me negative 4x squared. I have a plus 9 and a plus 1 for plus 10. All right, let's look at a few more. Subtraction again. I have 5x minus parentheses 11x minus 5. I'm going to keep, change, and change everything in the second or the polynomial that follows the old minus sign. What does that give me? I have 5x minus 11x is negative 6x, and I have plus 5 because it did not have any like terms. All right, you want to be very careful with expressions like number 5. It says subtract 18x squared plus 4 from 31x squared plus 2. The phrase subtract from, it tells us to write the 31x squared plus 2 down first and subtract from it 18x squared plus 4. Keep. Change, change. What does that give me? 31x squared minus 18x squared is 13x squared. And positive 2 and negative 4 is negative 2. So that's combining like terms. The last one says to subtract 5x plus 10 from, now when it says to subtract from, that means that the 5x plus 10 has to go over here. We're subtracting it from the sum of 7x plus 3 and 4x plus 11. So I'm subtracting it from the sum. Now you could find the sum first and then subtract, or you could say that is preceded by a positive 1, so I'll just drop it out of parentheses. This is preceded by a positive 1, so I'll drop it out of parentheses. This is preceded by subtraction. You can think of it as the change, change, You can think of it, which I haven't written it this way, but you could, that you're distributing a negative 1, so that's going to become minus 5x and minus 10, which is what I would have gotten if I had said, keep all this, change. There's my negative, there's my negative. All right, now, like terms. I have a 7x and a 4x and a minus 5x. 7 and 4 gives me 11, and 11 minus 5 is 6x. Then I have 3 plus 1 is 4, minus 10 is negative 6. I end up with 6x minus 6. Okay, that's adding and subtracting polynomials by adding and subtracting like terms.